In this chapter, we're talking about mailboxes, or a way of transferring data between tasks. Eric, this is not the cue you're looking for.
Is that my cue to talk about mailboxes?
It is, and cues, and whatever else.
And cue it up, Eric. All right, bad joke. Sorry about that. So in this chapter, we're going to talk about, in general, there are different ways to send data between threads.
Yes.
You could use globals. Bad idea for most embedded programmers.
Yeah.
You could also use queues and also mailboxes. Now, in free RTOS, they call TI-RTOS mailboxes are queues in
free
RTOS.
Queues in free RTOS, that's right. So let's talk a little bit about what the mailbox is here in this case, right? That's what we're doing this chapter.
Yeah, so mailbox is really the traditional common way of sending data between threads or between tasks. It's a finite size, a container that you can put something in. That's the person who's posting the information. And then the receiver, most likely a task,
takes
the data out. And there's a signaling mechanism built in to Mailbox, which is a really nice service by TI-RTOS.
So Mailbox is a good way to transfer data, and is that what we're doing in the lab?
Correct. So what we're going to do in the lab is extend the previous lab. Basically, the trigger coming from the interrupt, or from the clock function, that's going to unblock the first task that says, okay, we're going to take the value of the LED from 0 to 1, and that value is going to be passed through a mailbox to a secondary thread that actually blinks the LED. So the value of 0 or 1, the value of the LED is going to be passed through that mailbox.
So we're basically adding a task and letting another task do the actual toggling.
That's correct.
By sending something through the mailbox.
Yep, pretty simple.
Oh, that sounds pretty cool. Let's give it a try.
All right.
Welcome to Chapter 11, Using Mailbox. So what's the chapter goal and objectives? We've got one main goal, that's to learn about mailboxes, how to create mailboxes, and we're going to use that in the lab, actually, to blink an LED. What are the objectives? We're just going to look at data sharing methods or data passing methods, and how do we create a mailbox and pass values between threads, basically tasks.
So you can actually light an LED with a mailbox?
Of course you can.
Oh, that's cool.
So what are we going to do in the lab? So in the previous lab, we used a clock function that posted a semaphore that unblocked a task that toggled the LED. So we're going to add a mailbox in between. So we're going to add this task 1 function in between the clock function and the task 2 function. What happens is the clock function is still going to go off. It's still set up the way it was in the previous lab. It posts semaphore 1, which unblocks this middle task, task 1 function. And what does it do? It sets the value of the LED. So it does an exclusive or it's 0, then 1, then 0, then 1, then 0, then 1. It does a mailbox post of that value, 0 or 1. The other task is pending, waiting for that message, that value, and then makes the LED whatever value that is. So that's where we're headed with this chapter.
With semaphores, effectively, we're just synchronizing. We're just saying, hey, ready type of thing. But with mailbox, we're actually moving data.
We're actually moving data.
Cool.
So as far as the outline goes, we're going to talk about the basic ways to pass data between threads. Then we're going to actually look at how a mailbox works. And then once we understand how a mailbox works, let's go create one. How do you actually create a mailbox dynamically? Then at the end, we're going to do lab 11, where we actually go get to play with mailbox and make it so.